Good morning, class. How many uniformly accelerated motion variables are there?
Five.
And how many UAM equations are there?
Four.
And if you know how many of the UAM variables?
Three.
You can figure out the other?
Two.
Which leaves you with one?
Happy physics student.
I always like that.
I do too.
Flippin' physics.
Yeah.
Good. Now I am going to introduce alternate versions of all four of these equations. The first equation is v equals v sub 0 plus a times t, or velocity equals velocity sub 0 plus acceleration times time. There are many differences between this first UAM equation and our original first UAM equation. Let's begin by looking at how we have replaced change in time with just the variable time. Bobby, what does change in time equal?
Change in a variable always equals final minus initial, so change in time equals time final minus time initial.
Correct. Now we replace time final with the variable time, with no subscript, and we assume the initial time is zero. Therefore, change in time equals just the time variable. The letter we use for constant acceleration, A, is the same as before. Instead of velocity initial, v sub I, we have v sub 0 or v naught. The naught here is the digit 0. It means the velocity at time 0, hence v naught. The word naught in math means 0.
And we know the initial velocity is the velocity at the initial time, and that initial time equals 0. We showed that when we showed change in time equals the time variable. Right, Mr. P?
Correct, Billy. And just like we use the time variable without a subscript instead of time final, we also use the velocity variable without a subscript instead of velocity final. The second uniformly accelerated motion equation in the new form is this. Bo, please read the equation and explain to me the differences between this and our original form of this equation.
Our new second UAM equation is position equals position naught plus velocity naught times time plus 1/2 acceleration times time squared. So the letter A for constant acceleration is again the same as before. We have the same differences as before. We have replaced velocity initial with velocity naught, and we have replaced change in time with time. Now we have replaced position initial with position naught and replaced position final with position. But how is that the same as having change in position on the left side of the equation?
Oh, subtract position naught from both sides of the equation and you have position minus position naught on the left-hand side. That's the same thing as position final minus position initial, which is change in position. So it's the same thing.
Nice.
Great, thank you. The third new UAM equation is velocity squared equals velocity naught squared plus 2 times acceleration times the quantity position minus position naught. And the fourth UAM equation is position minus position naught equals 1/2 times the quantity velocity plus velocity naught all times time. Now, this fourth UAM equation is not on the AP equation sheet for some reason. However, you are welcome to use it. Okay, Billy, please take the derivative of the new second UAM equation with respect to time.
Sure, the equation is position equals position naught plus velocity naught times time plus 1/2 times acceleration times time squared. And we are taking the derivative of that equation with respect to time. Well, let's start with the derivative of position naught with respect to time. How do we do that? How do we take the derivative of the initial position with respect to time?
Remember, the initial position is a constant number. The initial position does not change with respect to time. It's just the initial position. It is just a number.
Oh, so the derivative of the initial position or position naught with respect to time equals zero.
Because the derivative of a constant number equals zero. We showed that last time. That makes sense.
Okay, we are done with the first term, position naught. Now let's take the derivative with respect to time of velocity naught times time.
That works out to be just velocity naught.
Why?
Oh, it is just like the derivative of 5t with respect to time equals 5. Velocity naught is just a constant number, just like 5.
Yeah, thanks.
And now the derivative with respect to time of 1/2 acceleration times time squared. Well, we know we multiply the term by 2 and raise to the power of 1. The 1/2 is a constant number, so that just stays at 1/2. But what about acceleration? What do we do with that?
Acceleration is constant, just like V naught, so you just leave it as acceleration.
Right. That is what uniformly accelerated motion means. The acceleration is constant.
So the derivative of this position equation with respect to time equals velocity naught plus acceleration times time.
Very nice, y'all.
Thank you.
What are we waiting for?
Are we missing something?
Please tell me when you see it.
That is the first UAM equation.
What?
The derivative of position with respect to time is velocity. So we just derived the equation velocity equals velocity naught plus acceleration times time.
Oh.
Actually, that equation tells us the instantaneous velocity of an object equals the velocity of the object at time zero plus the acceleration of the object times the time at which the instantaneous velocity occurs. That is an equation for instantaneous velocity.
Correct, everyone. Taking the derivative of the second uniformly accelerated motion equation with respect to time gives us the first UAM equation. In order to be able to take derivatives like this, we have these new expressions for the uniformly accelerated motion equations. Also realize that, using calculus, we begin to see relationships form between equations which, using only algebra, were more difficult to see before. When we get to integrals, we will be able to derive all of the UAM equations starting with the definition of acceleration. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.